Hi, this is Snow Queen. You're watching Dante Boxing Nation. You can follow me on my Instagram at Snow Queen LA. Hey.
Your dad said you would be a champion in 15 fights, and that you would be fighting Vasily Lomachenko in your 16th fight. Who do you want next?
You guys know who you want, man. 2020, it'll be going down.
Vasily, you famously said, "Who is this Teofimo?" Now he is a world champion. Do you want to fight him to unify?
Yes, of course. Now he's a world champion, and welcome to my club.
Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? So it's just been reported Teofimo Lopez has thought things over, changed his mind, and is now accepting the top rank offer to fight against Vasyl Lomachenko. This is great news, guys. I mean, it's not a guarantee that the fight is official and signed yet, but it's a step in the right direction. For any of you guys that missed my previous reports on this fight, it was about 2 weeks ago that Lomachenko had surprised everyone by being the first person to sign the contract and agree to all terms to fight Lopez. Now, once Loma agreed to all terms, we thought that it was going to be smooth sailing when it comes to this fight being announced very soon. But to our surprise, we found out that Teofimo Lopez, he wasn't happy with the money that he was offered from Top Rank. Because of the pandemic, because they're most likely going to be fighting in a fanless arena, which means that they're not going to bring in the revenue that Top Rank and ESPN wanted them to bring in, they were still offering Teofimo Lopez $1.2 million. But Lomachenko was getting 3.2 or something like that. So because of this, Lopez and his team, they said that they were going to walk away from this fight, fight someone else, and come back to the table later on. So Lomachenko, they start talking about fighting someone else. They were looking at Felix Verdejo. And then all of a sudden, Bob Arum, he comes out with this report and he says, and I quote, "Lopez has come to his senses and he understands that the money isn't there for him to get his desired purse," end quote. Listen, guys, in the sport of boxing, sometimes you have to gamble. You have to bet on yourself. And I think it was wise for Tio to do that in this situation. We know how successful Floyd Mayweather became after he bet on himself. You know, a lot of people don't know this, but Oscar De La Hoya, when Floyd Mayweather fought Oscar De La Hoya, that's what made Floyd Mayweather a big star. He fought the biggest cash cow in the sport of boxing at the time. Because he beat him, the bet paid off. Because Floyd Mayweather became bigger than Oscar De La Hoya and became more successful than Oscar in every single aspect. But the most important thing that Lopez and everyone else needs to know about Floyd Mayweather's situation is Floyd Mayweather was forced to take a very, very small slice of the pie for the De La Hoya fight, which at the time was the biggest pay-per-view fight of all time. I mean, if you think about it in hindsight, Oscar De La Hoya, he had so many demands in that fight that it almost came off as if he was negotiating, trying to negotiate himself out of a fight. So I think it really surprised Oscar De La Hoya when Floyd actually said yes to everything. But once again, when it came to the purse split of the fight, Floyd Mayweather got like a 80-20 or 75-25 split with Oscar De La Hoya. So the financial situation was way worse for Floyd Mayweather than it was for Teofimo Lopez. But it paid off for Floyd because he gambled on himself. He bet on himself. And that's what Teofimo Lopez is doing right now, at least if he signs the contract to fight him next. I'm really excited to hear this news that Lopez has come to his senses, as Bob Arum put it. This is one of the most significant fights of the year because it could easily change the whole boxing landscape. You have Lomachenko, who could easily be considered top two, one of the best fighters in the world, going up against someone who's trying to take his seat. So while boxing fans needed this fight, Lopez, he needed this fight even more. Because if he would have let Loma off the hook, who knows if Loma's going to lose to someone else? Who knows if he'll ever get a shot again? I mean, there's already a lot of killers at the lightweight division. And, you know, the guys that Loma struggled against, they weren't even on the levels of a Devin Haney or a Ryan Garcia or a Lopez. So it's very possible that Lopez could pass up on this opportunity and someone else could beat Lopez or beat Loma first. Or Loma could just play hard to get and say, you know what, I'm not fighting Lopez anymore. He walked away from the table when he had a grand opportunity. So he lost his chance. This is why it's very important for Lopez to take the fight right now. Because if he were to beat Lomachenko, then he could say, okay, Loma, you want a rematch? Now I'm going to get the $3 million and you get the $1.2 million. If it's worth that much for you to get a rematch, if not, we'll just go our separate ways. And you'll just have to remember the last guy you lost to was me.
And that's how you play that situation. That's all I got for now, guys. I'm on to the next one.
Fellas, I've got some great news for you. If you've lost your hair or have a receding hairline, the time has come when you can finally get your hairline back through a process called scalp micropigmentation. So here's how it works. It's a hair tattoo that replicates the look of your hair follicles when you have fully shaved it down. Basically, you will end up with a haircut shape up or an edge up. What they do is they tattoo small dots that look like hair follicles in the areas where you have lost your hair and then blend it with your existing hair. You can even choose what type of hairline you want, hard shape up or soft and natural finish. And to maintain it, all you gotta do is shave your hair every few days, which is something you already were probably doing anyway. So if you wanna get this hookup for my brothers out there in the UK and Europe, make sure you check out The Scalpedist on Instagram. And for my brothers out there in the States, make sure you go ahead and contact my man Scalp Carolinas on Instagram. And when you go on their pages, you can see for yourself what these guys look like before. I mean, these guys are literally hair magicians. I've never seen anything like this before. But all I can tell you guys is this is a serious game changer for us men. So make sure you get in contact with Scalpedist and Scalp Carolinas on Instagram.